Hi friends, welcome to the new series JavaScript Hero to Superhero. In this series, I'm talking about some advanced concepts in JavaScript. If you are a beginner trying to learn JavaScript, there is another series, JavaScript Zero to Hero, in which I have explained all the basic concepts. In this video, I'm going to talk about event propagation in JavaScript. First, what are events in JavaScript? Events are occurrences that can trigger certain functionality and can result in certain behavior. Example, we have click event, we have mouse over event, etc. Okay, now what is event propagation? Event propagation means how events travel through the DOM tree. Event bubbling and event capturing are the two phases of propagation. Bubbling travels from the target to the root. That means on the DOM element where the action is actually happening to the root element. The root is the highest level parent of the target. This is usually the document. Capturing travels from the root to the target element. Let me explain using an example. I have created a HTML in which I have a parent div inside the body element. And inside the parent div, I have a child div. And further inside the child div, I have a grandchild div. I have applied some CSS, and so we can see this. Okay, here I have also added a script file in which I am accessing each div element using their respective IDs. And I am adding a click event on each. So I am expecting when parent div is clicked, this message will be shown. When child div is clicked, this message will be shown, and so on. Let's try. When I click parent div, we can see this message. Good. But when I click grandchild div, we can see all three messages. This is because of event propagation. To be precise, event bubbling. The event is bubbled from this target element to the root element. And so all the events in between are triggered. Here we can pass another parameter, true, to change this to event capturing. By default, it is going to be event bubbling. But when we pass the parameter as true, it is going to be event capturing. Let's try now. Now we can see parent is clicked first, and then child, and then grandchild. Here the event is propagating from the root to the target element. This is event capturing. If we change it to false, it is going to behave like event bubbling. So instead of passing false, we can ignore that. And so it is going to behave like event bubbling. I hope you understood the difference between the event propagation phases, bubbling and capturing. Okay, now let us see how we can stop the event propagation. We have an inbuilt function called stop propagation. Let me show you how we can use that to stop the propagation. So here I can get the event and call the stop propagation function. Now if I try, we can see the event is not propagating. In most of the interviews, I have seen many people confuse stop propagation with prevent default. So I am going to tell you the difference between these two using another example. I have created another HTML application similar to the previous one. Here I have a table in which I have two rows. In each row, I have three columns. In the last column, I have a checkbox. Here also, I have applied some CSS, and so we can see this. In each row, I'm calling a function on click. On clicking that function, assume we are fetching some data from database. So we can see this in console. Now we have the checkbox also, right? Assume we are having this checkbox to select the row so that we can delete the row from the table. So if I check the checkbox, we can see checkbox is checked. But we can also see the function is also executed. And so there will be a fetch call to database. This is because of event propagation. Actually, for this use case, we don't want to hit the database when we want to select it to delete. So we need to stop the propagation. So let me add another click event in this column and pass the event as parameter. And in this function, I can get the event and call stop propagation method. Now, if I click the checkbox, we can see the checkbox is checked, but the event is not propagated. And so this function is not called. In the meantime, as we are not stopping the event propagation in the first row, we can see the event is propagated. Okay, let's see how prevent default is working. So here in this checkbox, let me add a function and pass the event as parameter. And then inside this function, let me call prevent default. Now if I click, we can see the event is propagated And so we can see this function is also invoked, but we can see the checkbox is not checked because we are preventing the default action of the checkbox. This is the use of prevent default. Hope you understood. And I believe you like this video. Please subscribe and support me. I'll be back with another concept soon. Thank you. Bye.